104.9 The Morning X at 8:15. It's Lori and Kev. I want to tell you real quick about a movie called Love's Park. It's coming out on Valentine's Day on Amazon. We're sitting here right now with Carol Rhyu. Now, I looked at IMDb. Carol, welcome to the show, first of all.
Thanks for having me.
We're glad you're here. I looked at IMDb, and you basically did everything on this movie. I'm going to list some credits I found on IMDb.
No way.
And I'm not sure how accurate IMDb is, so I'm going to list credits, and you say guilty or not guilty, okay?
Okay, okay.
Writer.
Guilty.
Director.
Guilty.
Producer.
Guilty.
Art director.
Guilty.
Casting.
Guilty.
And film editing.
Guilty.
I'm exhausted just thinking about trying to do all of those things at once.
So the date of the movie on IMDb was 2017. So there was a long process between making the movie and coming out on Amazon. When did you sleep?
I know, basically. So it was like January of 2018. I was like, I was going to do a release of myself. But then I met a distribution company, and they were like, we'll take it on. And so they took the film out to the markets, so all over the world. And, yeah, it sold to China. So the Chinese were pretty pleased with Love's Park.
Yeah.
And then, basically they wanted to do an online release for the film.
Okay. That is so cool.
So you asked us not to make you describe the movie. Can I give it a shot? Can I
give
the synopsis a shot?
Yeah.
So what it seems like is that there's a woman who is having some relationship struggles after her father-in-law dies, and they have to come back and take over the family business in Love's Park.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So this is a factory in Love's Park, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So why set a story like this in Love's Park?
Oh, well, I actually, my ex is actually from Rockford, so he actually introduced me to Love's Park, and I was like, oh my God, I love this town. It has a big heart on their water tower. This was like 2005. And then I went to film school, and then they said, like, what kind of movie would you like to direct? And I was like, oh, I want to make this movie about Love's Park. And it's been a long process for the writing of it. It was, like, on and off for many years. And I was actually in Los Angeles when I shot the movie. And so it's just been something I've been developing for a long time. So super excited to actually get it released.
So it's a drama, right?
Yes, drama. Mm-hmm.
So not a lot of fart jokes in the movie.
It's got some like dry humor in there.
There we go.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a little dry, but I think people will find some parts funny.
I saw some of the trailer.
Uh-huh.
It looks like you got some pretty good performances out of your actors.
Yeah.
So what was the experience like working with these actors?
Oh yeah, it's great. So I did shoot most of the movie in Los Angeles, but they have so many talented actors out there, and they're SAG or union or non-union. But I wanted to work with I worked a little bit with union and non-union actors, so it was good. It was good. Yeah, they mostly took my direction.
Mostly. What is it like with the casting process? You know, trying to find the perfect person for your roles that you've envisioned. Like
yeah.
You said, it's been since 2005 you've been, you know, toying around with this
right.
idea. So what was it like to finally like see someone and be like, oh yeah, that's exactly the part you should play?
Right. So I think the first, it was about a month of casting, and I put out my notices, like this was kind of the characters that I'm looking for. And it turned out that they were way more expressive than what I had on paper, because I was like, wow, like I didn't even know that this could happen in a character. So
right.
What I did with the characters, I took the actors and I kind of stretched it a little bit. So it's not super realistic. Like the style of acting is kind of a little bit surreal, like very sometimes over the top, but it's more to create that tension.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
That's what you do. You got to tell a story, you
mm-hmm.
know, and if you can do it through the performances, that's great.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
If you don't have to spell everything out, that's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Would you consider yourself a heavy-handed director then?
What's heavy-handed mean?
Heavy-handed. Meaning like, this is what I want and you're going to give it to me.
Or like kind of like take after take?
Like, you left out the word of in that sentence, and every single word needs to be in there.
You know what I've done? I think I'm like somewhere in the middle, like not super anal.
So not too bad is what
but
you say.
But I did like kind of the lead actress. I did kind of want to subdue her character a little bit because she's kind of an interesting observer to her life. So sometimes we have this depressing period of our lives where like things are happening to us, but we're not actively
right.
a part of it. So I think that was one of the challenges, because most characters in movies are active. They're like, you know, on some big challenge, on some big mission. So this is sort of the opposite of that.
Now, yeah. Is it challenging? You mentioned that you did a lot of the shooting in L.A.,
uh-huh.
but it is, you know, based on Love's Park,
yeah.
which is obviously here in the Midwest.
Right.
So how are you able to bring that Midwestern vibe to L.A. in order to portray that portray it.
Yeah, I think it just comes from where I'm from because I grew up in the suburbs. I grew up in Buffalo Grove.
Mm-hmm.
And so I've always had that sort of mentality. So me coming out to LA is a fish out of water.
Oh, but totally.
Actually, but there's a lot of Midwest filmmakers out there. And I think I just won it.
Yeah,
yeah,
seriously.
Like, you know, this is kind of, and there is some like Midwest vibe in there. So I feel... I think what it throws people off though is that it looks totally LA. Like it
really?
Looks, and the way we shot it looks kind of like a Hollywoody,
a Hollywood
shimmer.
Version of LA.
Yeah,
or I mean, of Love's Park.
Like a shiny kind of like stylized version of
the
it.
The benches, you know, that are painted
sure.
in Love's Park. They're
yeah.
covered in gold.
Yeah, I love Wes Anderson movies and David Lynch movies, which are super weird. So
right.
I kind of wanted to push it.
Very stylized. Yeah, for
yeah.
sure. Yeah, and in Love's Park. So you didn't have like your act. Come out here and experience Love's Park.
I wanted to shoot in Love's Park, so I applied for the Illinois. They have like a grant, or not a grant, it's a film credit,
mm-hmm.
but you need to spend $100,000. So I was like, oh, I just don't have that budget. So I just shot most of it in LA, but I did. I did come here by myself with my mom to shoot the water tower because that was
oh, that's great.
That was the main like centerpiece of me feeling connected to the actual city.
That's
right.
Great. If anybody who lives here sees the movie, they'll see that and
they'll
be like,
see the water tower.
That's
yes.
my hometown.
Yeah, I mean, I've been there. I've
seen
that.
It?
Yeah,
I love it. It's just so endearing.
And what's great is that like not only is it Love's Park, but you're also touching a little bit upon the manufacturing.
Mm-hmm.
Aspect of this area. I mean, this is a
yes.
huge manufacturing mm-hmm. area. Do you have any background in that?
Well, actually, my ex, he has they install fire sprinklers.
Mm-hmm.
So it was inspired by, like, you know, him taking over the business. And then, I mean, but, like, I had been creating my own, like, version of that. And, yeah, like, even my dad, he was a factory worker. And so I remember when he was transitioning out of those jobs, like, he just couldn't keep a job. Because
yeah.
it was like they were being run out by, I don't know, automation. And I think it's sort of relevant because we are still facing
yeah,
in every
absolutely.
Industry, like music, even films being all streamable. Like a big dream was.
And radio.
Yeah, and radio.
Radio's being pushed out by digital, too. Yeah.
See, yeah. So we're all kind of experiencing on different levels.
That's
Man.
Amazing. So this comes out on Valentine's Day. How many people so far have seen the film?
Ooh, gosh, like 5.
That's it.
I know. It's so it's so eerie to actually have it released. I don't know. It's been haunting me.
On Valentine's Day, was that accidental or does that coincide with it being called Love's Park?
It does coincide. We thought it's not a super like happy-go-lucky film, so it's kind of our anti-Valentine. It's
even
our, yeah.
better.
I like
yeah.
that.
Yeah. It's a dark love. It's
I
a
like,
dark
that's
story.
How we, that's how we feel about Valentine's Day around
Me too.
Here, too.
Yeah. Like, yeah. I haven't celebrated that for many years.
Last year we did Singles Awareness Day instead.
Uh-huh.
SAD for short. So we're right in all along with that vibe. It comes out on Amazon. Can you get this on Amazon Prime Video?
Yeah, you can. Mm-hmm. I've got Amazon Prime Video, so I look forward to seeing it. I'll put it on my watch list.
Yay.
There we go.
Carol, we would love to keep you around, like, forever.
Yeah.
Because you're great. Well, unfortunately, we are out of time, but anything else you want to say before we let you go?
Oh, I hope you guys enjoy the film. Just be patient. The first half is kind of meant to draw you out of your normal element. So,
ooh, yeah, good
it's
to
a
know.
Good movie.
Let
good
yourself
know.
Be told a story for once.
Yes, we'll put the trailer up on our Facebook page, facebook.com/TheXRockford. Also, you can find more at facebook.com/Love's Park Film.
And again, that comes out Valentine's Day on Amazon. Carol, thank you very much for joining
Thanks
us
so
today.
Much.
It's 104.9 The Morning X.
It's Lori and Kev on 104.9 The Morning X.